Welcome back to the Movie Trivia Schmodown. I am excited, and I'm Christian Harloff.
I am Mark Ellis. Christian, every road that has ever been built in the history of civilization stops right here. We have the reigning champion from Movie Fights, the reigning champion of the Movie Trivia Schmodown. And man, are there some subplots. There's more storylines today than in my favorite movie of the summer, Mother's Day.
Unbelievable stuff. Listen, this is Ali Frazier. This is Liddell and Couture at their prime. This is the best of the two that we have in the Schmodown, and they have history. Like you said, these guys were teammates in the tournament last year, and then they split up. Mark Reilly went his way. Merle went his way. Like you said, Merle has not ever lost a championship match in Movie Fights, and neither has Reilly, but a zero has to go.
You know, when the Movie Trivia Schmodown was just a dream in a couple boys' hearts with nothing more in their pockets than a song, we thought one day maybe something like this could possibly go down. Now it feels like a huge boxing match or a huge UFC event, except these guys, thankfully, keep their shirts on.
All right, so Mark, obviously the fans have been going crazy. The crowd here is gonna be going crazy.
But let's hear it, everybody. Who's in there?
It's a big one. It's a big one.
I can't hear myself think.
It is a big match. They are pumped. They are ready to go.
Oh, Christian, I mean, this thing blew up social media all over the place and has been for quite some time, and now it is finally here upon us. Let's go to the tale of the tape.
Well, there you go. You see, they both have a vast knowledge of movies. Dan Merle can hit you with Spielberg, Oscar movies, and again, wearing glasses very well. And then you have Mark Reilly, known for classics, scores, and soundtracks, and having amazing hair.
You know what? Both these guys are fantastic at getting in the ring and not buckling under the white hot pressure of the spotlight. Dan Merle, we've seen what he can do on Screen Junkies. He can get the like button way up there, unless he's talking about Ghostbusters, then the dislikes start to appear. And Mark Reilly, this guy just, he keeps going. He's a workmanlike attitude, but he always has that Superman jacket ready to go. Will we see that today?
I don't know. You never know. He's known for his entrances. We'll find out today. I'm ready.
You're known for your amazing golden throat.
Thank
you
so
much.
Ready?
I'm ready. You been practicing?
I have been in the shower. Are you ready to go?
Let's hear it, buddy.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the Movie Trivia Championship match, scheduled for 5 rounds. Introducing first, representing Screen Junkies with a record of 2 wins, no defeats. He is the reigning Movie Fights champion and the number one contender, Dangerous Dan Merle.
America,
there he is.
There he is.
Unbelievable.
Is that the warm-up? Is that the warm-up of Rocky Balboa, of Apollo Creed? He is definitely pro Gotham City, and he looks like a big fan of America.
This is good, good stuff.
He is a true T-Rex of the Movie Trivia Schmodown.
And his opponent, needing no introduction in the Movie Trivia Schmodown, representing Collider, the Wolves of Steel, and Schmoes Know, with a record of 5 wins, no defeats, with 3 knockouts. He is the 2014 Ultimate Schmodown winner and the reigning, defending Movie Trivia Schmodown champion of the world, Mark Keone Reilly!
Mark Reilly representing Superman. Double time, bringing out his belt to counter Dan Merle's Movie Fights belt. What an entrance. What a pair of entrances. We just had Christian. I don't know that I've ever seen your face get that red. It was like watching a thermometer in the heat of summer.
I am a rotten tomato. All right, here we go. This is a little different. Oh, both the belts are out. Look at that. That is a sight. Okay, so we are going. It's a little different. This is 5 rounds, Mark. Why don't you tell them first how round one goes?
5 big rounds. We're not going to throw every rule that we have today at you guys, because we don't want to overload your gray matter right off the bat. In round one, it's very simple. Just like a run-of-the-mill Schmodown, you guys will each get 6 questions from 6 different movie categories. Each question is worth 1 point. There is no stealing in this round. There is no penalty for getting a question wrong. Gentlemen, you guys ready to answer some questions?
Let's do this.
Let's do it.
All right, Mark Riley, you are the reigning champion. You can either go first or second.
I'll go first.
You'll go first.
I like the cockiness.
All right, Dan Merle, you choose from category one or category two?
Two.
Two. All right, Mark Riley, in the category of 80s movies, how many gigawatts of electricity did Doc Brown need to power the DeLorean in Back to the Future?
1.21 gigawatts.
Correct.
You know, he's wearing sunglasses. I don't think he blinked, Christian.
All right. Mark Riley, in the category of animated, name a voiceover artist who lent their talents in the film WALL-E.
What's that guy's name?
Five, four.
John Ratzenberger.
Correct.
Better known as Cliff from Cheers, Christian. Yeah.
Mark Riley, in the category of comedies, which comedy features the fictional companies Intertech and Intertrip?
Fictional companies Intertech and Intertrip.
Five, four, three, two,
honestly,
one.
Oh, God.
The answer is Office Space.
Oh,
damn. Dan Merle knew that one.
Son of a bitch.
Right,
Riley, what is it you would say you do here? Now we move on to Dan Merle. We know what he's doing here. He's here
he's
take a belt and rob Mark Riley of the championship. Dan Merle in the round of comedy, 80s movies. Dan Merle in 80s movies. What fraternity do Lewis and Gilbert join in Revenge of the Nerds?
Oh, boy. I know a lot of 80s movies. I don't know Revenge of the Nerds that well. Delta Psi.
Looking for Lambda, Lambda, Lambda.
Wow, I'm surprised that Dan Merle missed that one.
He's too cool to be in the Tri-Lams. Right. Now we move on to animated. Who voiced the fox Nick Wilde in the film Zootopia?
Jason Bateman.
Dan Merle,
correct.
Right
Dan
on the board. Give him a point.
That's it.
And now, Dan, in comedies, what department store did Ash work for in Army of Darkness?
It was a sporting goods store. Kmart.
Very close to looking for S-Mart.
S-Mart.
S-Mart. Probably couldn't get the rights to Kmart way back in 1993.
There you go. Mark Riley, in the category of horror, what Oscar-winning actor plays the Headless Horseman in full form in Tim Burton's Sleepy Hollow?
Christopher Walken.
Correct. All right. All right, Mark Riley, in the category of fantasy sci-fi, in Terminator 2, which human is most directly responsible for the creation of Skynet?
Miles Dyson.
Correct.
Ooh, oh, boy.
All right, Mark Riley, in the category of Oscar movies, who received Oscar nominations for playing the title roles in 1967's Bonnie and Clyde?
William Beatty and
five, four, three, two.
Don't happen.
The answer is Warren Beatty and Faye Dunaway.
Dunaway, right.
I don't know that Faye Dunaway or Warren Beatty has ever looked better. And now we're on to Dan Merle. Dan, your question in the category of horror. Who played Jack Nicholson's book editor rival, who also gets turned into a werewolf, in the film Wolf?
Oh, my God. Wolf. Classic horror film, Wolf. Michelle Pfeiffer.
Looking for James Spader. James Spader. Spader.
Classic film, Wolf.
Classic Wolf.
Wolf is a good movie. Everybody
Every
start
Halloween
commenting
I
right
pop
now.
In Wolf
kicks ass. All right. In the realm of fantasy sci-fi, what's the name of the second Chronicles of Narnia film?
This one was obviously The Lion, Witch, and the Wardrobe. I only did three. I believe the second one was Prince Caspian.
And he's dreamy as well. Give him a point.
And now the final question in the final category of round one. Already a great matchup. Oscar movies, Dan. What Christopher Nolan film was nominated for Best Picture?
Inception.
Another point for
Dan.
Wow,
look at that. Look at that. At the end of round one, the champion is up 4-3. Mark, as we get into round two, why don't you tell them the rules?
Round two is where it can all change and the stakes have elevated because a wheel is going to magically appear, mainly because we pay somebody to bring it out. Josh McCuga, in this case, and the wheel has 14 different movie categories on it. Each competitor will spin the wheel. If you don't like the category that you spin, you are allowed to have a mulligan. However, if you spin a category the next time, you got to answer four questions from that category. Each question is worth 2 points. If you want to use your multiple choice option, you may. The point value then goes down to 1 point. Keep in mind, there is stealing available in this round.
Mark Reilly, you are in the lead. Would you like to spin first or defer?
I'm going to spin this thing.
All right, do it. Give it a good spin, please.
He's no stranger to that wheel. That's a fine spin, Christian.
That's good. Better than I thought. What did it land on?
It's like sports.
Is that sports?
Athletics.
There's the spin. Oh.
That's a Kal-El spin or a Jor-El spin.
Yeah, I like it. And it's going to land on.
Fantasy sci-fi.
What is that?
I'll take it.
What is it?
Fantasy sci-fi.
It lands on fantasy sci-fi. Big category for Reilly.
That is an all-star category for Mark Reilly. You have the Christian. Ask him questions.
All right. All right, Mark Reilly.
Yes.
In Jurassic Park, what animal's DNA do they use to fill in the gaps in the dino DNA?
A frog.
Correct. Big 2 points there. All right. Mark Reilly in Men in Black. What does the J stand for in Agent J's name? Five.
J. The name J. J-A-Y.
Incorrect. Would you like to steal that?
I believe it's James.
That is correct.
6-5. 2-point highway robbery.
Wow. Surprise, Mark Reilly didn't go for multiple choice.
Shocking.
There. All right. Mark Reilly in Looper. How is a looper paid when the services are no longer required, ending the looper's contract?
They're killed. No, they're...
You want to steal?
I believe it's gold bricks.
We'll take gold bricks, gold bars. Dan Merle with the steal.
Damn.
All right. What is the name of the alien race that tries to take over Earth in Star Trek First Contact?
The Borg.
Correct.
Oh, my God. He needed that 2 points, didn't he?
All right. There you go. So at the Mark Reilly has now made it 8-7. Dan Merle, you are up. Spin the wheel.
All right. Can I spin it toward me, or does it have to go that way?
You can spin it towards me.
In Australia, they spin it the other way.
Horror.
Scary category for Dan
What's
Merle.
What's Dan going to do?
We've proven that horror is a little hit or miss for me, so I'm going to go ahead and I'll take a second try.
Spin it again. Here we go.
You know, I just got it. He's Batman and Riley's Superman.
Yep. What's that?
That looks like
Arnie and Sly.
Arnie and Sly.
Arnold Schwarzenegger and Sylvester Stallone movies.
What?
Wow.
We'll see.
All right.
Yep. Okay. It's feast or famine on this one, guys, I think. Let's see what happens.
Okay, well, ladies and gentlemen, because Dan spun the Arnie and Sly category, we didn't know this was going to happen in the championship match, but we have a special guest here to ask the first question. Mr. Arnold Schwarzenegger, come on out, Arnold. Give him a hand.
All right,
here we go. Which way is he coming from?
He doesn't want to be on camera. He doesn't want to be on camera, so we got to make sure we have the contestants on. All right.
Okay, Mr. Dan Merle, who plays the villain in Cliffhanger?
Translating into English, who plays the villain in Cliffhanger?
That's what I said.
I love his British accent in the movie. It's John Lithgow.
2 points.
Yeah.
That's why they call him dangerous, Christian / Arnold.
There you go. Dan Merle takes his lead. All right.
And now we move on to your next question. Who directed Predator?
John McTiernan.
2 more points.
Dan Merle
for
taking
Dan
a nice
Merle,
lead.
I would have guessed Chris Hansen. Who played Stallone's daughter in the comedy Oscar? Who played Stallone's daughter in the comedy Oscar?
I need multiple choice on that one, Mark.
Was it A, Jennifer Aniston, B, Linda Fiorentino, C, Marissa Tomei, or D, Jennifer Connelly?
Marissa Tomei.
One more point.
Good guess.
For Dan Merle. And now, Dan, to really complete a kick-ass second round, what was Arnold Schwarzenegger's name in Commando?
Oh. I'm trying to think if I'm getting it mixed up with Predator or not.
Five.
I'm going to go multiple four. Choice.
Was it A, John Stone, B, John Matrix, C, Dutch, or D, John Kimble?
It was John Matrix.
What a round.
One
for Dan Merle.
More point.
Dutch.
So we have.
I couldn't remember if Dutch was Predator.
We have 13-8 going into the third round. All right. Mark, please explain the rules of round three.
Well, round three is pretty easy, and if you live in Vegas right now, it's going to be your favorite. It is the betting round. Whoever's in the lead, that would be Dan Merle in this case, because he's so dangerous, spins the wheel. Whatever that wheel lands on, we will ask you each a question from that category. Now, what you guys are going to do once you see the category is write down a point value that you're willing to wager based on your confidence in the trivia category.
Now, Dan, because you're in a lead, you can bet up to 5 points. Riley, you can bet up to 3 points.
All right. Dan, without further ado, give that baby another spin.
Arnie and Sly movies once again. All right.
Wow.
Arnie and Sly movies. Okay.
Yeah.
You need that one? Yep. Gentlemen, are you ready?
Yes.
Here we go. In what film is Arnold Schwarzenegger trying to decipher the riddle of steel? The question is, in what film is Arnold Schwarzenegger trying to decipher the riddle of steel? Okay. Kruger, please take the answers.
Feel the tension in here, Christian.
All right, here we go. Dan?
Dan, writing right up to the last second.
All right, let's start with Mark. Riley, how many points did you bet?
3.
And your answer?
Cell Block.
Dan, how many points did you bet?
Also 3.
And you bet?
I said End of Days.
They both lose points. The answer was Conan the Barbarian. So the score now is 10-5.
Oh, there you go.
Dan Merle is up 10-5 going in to the speed round, round 4.
Well, I hope they can solve this riddle a little bit better than the steel one. In round 4, this is the speed round where we are gonna ask 5 questions. Your name is your buzzer. If you know it, buzz in. If you don't, you better look out, because if you get a question right, you get a point. If you miss a question, you lose a point. So make sure you know the answer before you buzz in. Your name's your buzzer.
Josh McCouga, we need you once again. Please stand near the two competitors. Josh McCouga will let us know. You guys have to buzz in with your names. McCouga will let us know who got to it first if it's close. Stand in the middle, if you please, sir. Don't mind Willy Wonka. He'll only be there for a little while.
Never has humanity relied this much on Josh McCouga. I can't wait to see what the results are.
All right, here we go.
Okay, question 1. Name the year the following movies were released. Ordinary People, Stir Crazy, The Blues Brothers.
Dan, 1980.
One point correct. For Dangerous Dan Merle. 1 point for Dangerous Dan Merle. He could have lost a point. Yeah. Instead, he gained a point. And now we move on to question 2. In Disney's Aladdin, what was Aladdin's third and final wish?
Dan. Riley.
He wished the genie free.
He certainly did. He certainly did. Not what I would have wished for, but he did. In 1989, this film features the wind whispering, ease his pain.
Dan, Field of Dreams.
Another point for Dangerous Dan Merle, starting to run away with this match, Christian.
Name the actor who played Tom Cruise's best friend in Top Gun.
Dan.
Riley.
5, 4.
Yeah. Oh, Anthony Edwards.
Correct. 14, If Dan Merle answers this question, he has knocked out Mark Reilly.
Get out the broom.
All right. Here we go. Who played the father of the gifted child in 2016's Midnight Special?
Reilly. Michael Shannon.
Correct.
Well, Reilly, you know what? Listen to the crowd. And now, because of Mark Reilly's wily answer, with the last question in round four, we move on to round five. Either way, at the end of this round, we're going to have a champion of the movie trivia schmodown, either the reigning one or a new one. That belt could be going back to Screen Junkies, Christian.
All right, here we go. Dan Merle, you're in the lead. Please pick three numbers for your final round. Between 1 and...
2, 23.
23.
Right. 13, 19, and 7.
13, 19, and 7.
He went back. That's an intimidation.
Mark Reilly.
5, 18, and 9.
Well, you went back, too. I've never seen a double back before.
All right.
Mark Reilly, you are up first, and your one-point question category is comedies. Who plays the two con artists in Dirty Rotten Scoundrels?
Michael Caine and Steve Martin.
1 point for Mark Reilly. 1 point for Mark Reilly, and I believe we're going to stick with Mark Reilly now, Christian. Is that correct?
We are.
In the category of Oscar winners, name the Oscar-winning actress who starred in Fargo and Wonder Boys.
Frances McDormand.
All right.
3 points for Reilly. He has been awakened.
All right. We will do the one-pointer for Dan Merle.
One-pointer for Dan Merle.
Dan, based off a popular book series, in what 2004 movie does Count Olaf try to steal Violet, Klaus, and Sonny Baldaire's fortune?
Lemony Snicket's A Series of Unfortunate Events.
That's correct. 10, 15. Mark Reilly is up. It is the five-pointer. He needs to hit this, or Dan Merle has won the championship.
Well, you talk about Lemony Snicket. It would indeed be an unfortunate event if Mark Reilly did not get this question.
All right, here we go.
In the realm of science fiction fantasy, who played Arwen, the elven love interest of Aragorn, in The Lord of the Rings?
Liv Tyler.
There you
Steven
go.
Steven Tyler's daughter.
We are
Aerosmith kicks ass. That is Mark Reilly telling Dan Merle to shut up and dance.
Well, we'll see, because Merle still has 2 questions left to win the championship. We are tied at 15 right now in the category of Indiana Jones films. What is the full character's name of Indy's love interest in Raiders of the Lost Ark?
Marion Ravenwood.
And your winner and the new movie trivia showdown champion of the world, Dangerous Dan Morrow.
And they share a hug at the end of this.
They embrace each other, Batman and Superman. They're done fighting each other. The two belts are going back to Screen Junkies. And in a real show of class, Mark Reilly holding up Dan Merle's hand. Christian, we have been through it all, and I think this is going to be another famous chapter in the history of the movie Trivia Schmodown.
I can pretty much guarantee this is not the last time you see Merle and Reilly going at it. It is going to be a battle the next time these two titans get in the ring, but I want to hear from them. Let's go. Josh McCuga is there with the new champion, Dan Merle, and the former champ, Mark Reilly. Take it away, McCuga.
Oh, Schmodown Championship. We're here with the winner. Dude, Dangerous Dan Merle. I got to say, man, you are a buzzsaw, a human buzzsaw. How are you feeling right now? Two belts? Look at all that bling. You're louder than me right now.
I'm in shock. I can't believe it. Mark Reilly is a champion. He's always been a champion. This is beyond my wildest dreams. I can't believe this actually happened. I thought that I would be walking out of here empty-handed. I thought he would take this one too somehow. So this is amazing. This is an incredible feeling.
I think the tide of the match really turned. Second round, Reilly came in hot. You stole a couple from him. And then that speed round, you were the John Matrix of the speed round, let's be honest. Did you, I mean, your rapid fire knowledge, do you think it's easier to say Dan or it's harder to say Riley, or you just knew it?
It's maybe easier to say Dan. I don't know. I the first round threw me. I did not have a good first round. I thought this could be a short day. I thought he could KO me by the third or fourth round. I was shocked. You know, he took a lot of chances on that second round, and I was able to get in there and steal a couple points. And, yeah, the speed round is something that, you know, I don't know. I thought it'd be 50-50 every time, and he was just a second ahead of me on Midnight Special. But I'm glad he got it because he's a champ, and he deserves to take it all the way to the end.
All right, one last question before we get into what's next for Dangerous Dan Merle. Did you know her full name, or did you really have to go in the old memory bank for that one?
I knew her full name, but I wasn't sure if it was Ravenwood or Ravenswood. So, to be honest, it was a 50-50 shot in my head as to whether I had it right because I didn't know if that S was there.
Know your specifics, kids. Know your specifics. Okay, so what's next? Now, you hold the title. There will be an ultimate Schmodown tournament to face you for that belt. Do you want to compete each round of the tournament, or do you want to see who's left after the bloodbath that is the ultimate Schmodown?
I mean, listen, I'm of two minds. I would love to get in there every round and fight. That is class competition. But showmanship is something, and I love a build-up. I want steel to sharpen steel. I want the best of the best to clash against each other every single week. I want the best of the best to win every single week, and I want to face the absolute best of the best to win this belt, because if they take it from me, I want it to be fair and square. I want to face the best of the best.
Steel sharpens steel from Dan Merle. Okay, Dan, your immediate contenders, do you give Riley a rematch, or do you want the winner of San Levine Clark Wolf?
Boy, that's tough. I've seen all three of them play. They are all three of them ferocious, ferocious, ferocious people. In a way, I kind of think that Levine and Wolf should play, and then the winner of that should go against Riley to determine who gets a rematch. You know, I don't want to appoint who I get to fight next. I just want whoever it is to know that I'll be ready.
It is sometimes lonely at the top, but at the top, there lies two belts. Dangerous Dan Merle, congratulations on your win, man. All right, Schmodown fans, I'm here. Post-championship match with the former title holder, the former belt, the former champion, Mark Winston Riley. Mark, we all watched you, and I want to know what was going through your head in that second round.
You know what, Josh McCuga? What was going through my head? I was, the lights got to me. I'm not going to lie to you. Dan Merle is a beast, and those lights came to me. I thought I had a certain question with the Men in Black, and I thought it was a trick question, so I wanted to go for broke and not answer the or ask for the multiple choice. That turned out to be a bogus move on my end, which then led to a second question, which also sucked. But, you know, that was what was going through my head. That, and it was damn hot.
Now, you're a really smart guy, and the speed round came.
Yeah.
I know you knew those answers. He just so happened to be quicker. Each one, I heard you falling on it. Was that really, really frustrating for you? I mean, it had to be.
Yeah, it was really frustrating. That guy's, yeah, he's quick. He's got a sharp mind there. But, you know, I guess I needed a little bit of a nudging, because once I was on the ropes there, I was faster. So, next time.
How do you feel about the ultimate Schmodown going against Merle as the ultimate goal?
That would be fun, too. I'd be glad to go in the tournament, work my way back up. Either way, I want another shot at the belt. I'll go the long way. I'll take the shortcut. It doesn't matter.
Like Robert Frost said, you take the road less traveled by in the Schmodown. Those were the exact quotes. I'm not sure if you knew about that.
No, it was close. You're fine. Yeah.
You're good.
I'm here. Mark, you were the former champion, but you're always the champion in our hearts here at Collider and with Schmoes. Guys, that's it here with Mark Riley.
Well, there you go, Christian. It certainly was a clash of the titans. And as you alluded to before we went to Josh McCuga, our next matchup, maybe we see these guys again pretty darn soon.
You would assume that Riley is going to get a shot at that title once again really soon. It depends on when they can meet up again. You have the Ultimate Schmodown tournament coming in, where you're going to have the top eight contenders going for a battle for that spot. Will Clark Wolf get a shot at the belt? Will Sam Levine get a shot at the belt? What's going to happen next? All we know, we have a brand new champion, and he lives at Screen Junkies.
You know, it was a great run for Mark Riley, an unprecedented run, as a matter of fact, but I take my hairpiece off to Dan Merle. He earned it. He came in here today, and he was worth every penny. Yes, he wins a lot of movie fights. It's a different game, but I'll tell you what, that guy is a worthy champion of this show right here.
He really is. We're proud to have Dan Merle as the champion now of the Movie Trivia Schmodown. It is not the last we'll see of Mark Riley. Obviously, Dan Merle, 3 wins, no defeats, and he almost knocked out Mark Riley. Almost.
And we want to thank all the fans of Schmozno, of Collider, and of Screen Junkies, and especially the studio audience here. Thank you guys so very much for showing up. That is Christian Harloff. My name is Mark Ellis. Make sure you guys subscribe to the Collider Video YouTube channel. That's all for us today. We need a nap.
Wow.
Hey guys, if you like this video, click the thumbs up button. Also, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. It'll help you stay up to date with everything we've got going on here at Collider.